Hey, this is Mike. Before I get started, please hit the subscribe button. I know you're going to love my channel. I have hundreds of videos of all different makes and model vehicles, so it's a really good resource for checking out some cool cars, especially if you're in the market for buying one. So, I am here at Sparks Toyota in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and they are allowing me to check out this 2015 Toyota Prius V. Now, it's not an SUV. It's a Prius V. It has, I don't know if you're familiar with the Prius, they don't have a very big back like this. This one has a hatchback that's pretty good size, and it has a big back door, and just the overall back portion of the vehicle is larger and more capable. So I guess that's what the V is, SUV or something, but the Prius V is a really neat option in hybrids. Of course, it's a Toyota, so you've got some quality behind the name there. So you have these 16-inch alloy wheels with some chrome cladding, and it does have the four-wheel disc brakes, which is a plus. It does have the spoiler there in the back. And the windows have been tinted, so the dealer has added that, so that's not always like the way it looks now. So you have that spoiler there on the back, and that's just not to be cool, but it's also to be aerodynamic and give you better gas mileage. And you can slip through the air just a little bit easier with improvements like that. So let's check out the front here. It does have daytime running lights, and I guess the only way they turn on is when you're driving, so I can't really turn them on right now. But they do have the lights down here, and the headlights are a combination of projector and reflector. They're both halogen, powered by halogen bulbs, but the projector is a more focused beam for the low beam, and then the high beam is more scattered light, so that way you can get a basic floodlight. And hopefully I'll be able to do one of these at night sometime so you can see what they actually look like. But the projector system is a really good option, really good choice. And the front end of this vehicle is very striking. It definitely gets your attention when it's coming down the road and you look at it, you're like, wow, what is that? Okay, so let's take a look, start looking on the inside, starting with the passenger side. Now before I go in, something I want to show you with the key. The key is actually just this little box, and it is a proximity key, and as long as you have this in your pocket or your purse, just on you somewhere, then you can actually get in the vehicle and use the vehicle without actually taking this out of your pocket, ever. So just walking up to the car, all you have to do, as long as you have that key, it senses the proximity of the key. You just put your hand behind the handle and it'll automatically unlock. Right now it's already running, so I can't really demonstrate it. But you just put your hand behind the handle, and it senses your hand, it senses the key, and it unlocks for you. To relock it, you just put your finger right in this position here, and it'll relock. It's not gonna do it now because it's running and the key's not in there. When it's running, it's not gonna do it. So that's how you lock and unlock the doors without actually having a key in your hand. So here's the inside of the passenger side, and it does have some cloth material here, and some metallic accents around the door lock control and power window control. And then you have this textured plastic here, which kind of looks like, I don't know if that's wood grain or what that's supposed to be. And then this is a soft to the touch material here. You have the bottle holder there at the bottom, as well as some storage area. The seat is very comfortable, it has some good bolstering. It is a cloth seat with some texture there on the inside. And, you know, manual adjustments. And look at the height off the floor. It gives you good height to where your knees are not sticking up in the air. And this one has one and two glove compartments. So you've got plenty of storage space right there in front of you if you're sitting in the passenger side. And this is a soft to the touch material there, pretty soft. take a look at the window sticker. Alright, so let's look here in the back. Now you'll notice the back door is a little bit bigger than the front door, and I guess, you know, the design of this vehicle is so you can have a lot more cargo space than the other Prius vehicles. So it's basically the same thing on this as the cloth here, the soft of the touch stuff around, and then the bottle holder and the metal metallic accent. But I went ahead and move the seat up a little bit to show you that the seat does move up and forward and backwards, but also you have this little storage area behind the seat, a perfect place to put a full-size umbrella, which I thought was pretty cool. And also the seat folds down flat, and it has a plastic, hard plastic surface on the back of the seat in case you need to use it as part of your cargo area. So let me go ahead and put the seat back and then flip this up. So now you can see what the seat looks like. But you notice that other one is tilted back. That is because these are reclining seats. They can actually recline back so your back seat drivers can fall asleep and get comfortable. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that back down for right now so we can take a look at the cargo space. But look at the leg room. It's not too bad considering the front seat's all the way back, plus it's plenty of distance off the floor, so you get more comfort that way. Alright, let's take a look back here. So back here you got a pretty cool Toyota symbol with the blue on the inside. You also have your backup camera there, which I'll show you when we get on the inside. So to open it up, there's a little button just under here. You just push that. You can kind of lifts it itself up. So you can see you have plenty of cargo space. Tons of cargo space, and you can, you know, fold that other seat down if you needed to. And you know, you do have it goes into the sides are pretty far. You notice that they dish it out as much as possible to give you the maximum amount of cargo space. And you do have your tie downs. You have four of them on the corners. You also have a power supply back here. Now this is really cool. In here, not only does it have a shade, a retractable shade, but you have a place to put it. So it's already stored away for you. If you want to use it, you can put it in place across there and then use your shade and cover up your stuff. Or if you need to carry something big, you can just put it in here and it's completely out of the way. That's really awesome. Also, there's this whole storage area here too as well. So you got all this storage space, and you know, let me flip this back again. You do have some storage space in here under these covers. So lots of little cubbies to put stuff out of the way, out of sight. So that's pretty awesome. And overall, the opening of the back of the vehicle is pretty significant. All right. Now, this is a Prius, so you can use it has electric power and gas power, so you do have to put gas in it. And there's the fuel door. So let's go ahead and open that up so we can check it out. All right, so there's the fuel door, there's the fuel cap, and you'll notice the cap is tethered with this plastic string. And so instead of just unscrewing it and let it hanging down and scratch your paint, this is like a pearl coat paint, by the way. It does need to be washed, but it is a pearl coat paint. So they do have this little place here to hang up your cap, so that way it doesn't scratch down, you know, go down there and scratch your paint and all that stuff. And it's lockable, as you saw. Get another perspective on this side. It does have that plastic threshold there for to make it easy to get in and out of, and also protect your carpet so you're stepping on plastic versus the carpet there. All right, let's take a look under the hood, see what we can see. I'm sure there's a 1.8 liter engine in there, VVT system. and electric system in there, so that should be pretty fun if it's not covered up in plastic. Ooh, hybrid synergy drive. It is kind of covered up with some plastic. Hey, look at there, we've got some big orange wires there. Real smooth running engine, very smooth. For a four-cylinder, four cylinders usually have a little bit rougher, but alright. So there's that. 1.8 liter, four-cylinder system with the electric motor to power us, you know, to assist with your driving, get you better gas mileage. All right, so let's take a look on the inside. All right, here we are on the inside. And I like the way they leave this spot open for your knee to just, you know, extend out as much as possible. But it does have plenty of leg room and knee room for sure. So let's go ahead and start over here with the buttons on the driver's door. They're all automatic. All the windows are automatic. So it doesn't matter which one I push, I can, you know, just push it really hard and it'll automatically go down or up. Your door lock controls are here. You can lock out the other power windows if you want to using that button. And then your side mirror controls are here. You just have to pick a side and adjust it. You put it in the middle in order to keep it from, you know, messing up your adjusted mirrors. So here is your traction control button, and this is always on. The traction control is always on. It's a very good safety feature, but if you get stuck in the snow or something like that and you need to spin tires, you can always turn it off here if you need to, just temporarily. And then your dimmer switch for your interior light, for your interior gauge lights, is here right there. You have like a, I don't know what this thing is right here. I don't know if that's like for a car. I don't know what that's for. Maybe you can tell me. It doesn't blow. There's no air blowing out of it. But I hadn't been able to figure out what that little thing is. Maybe you can tell me in the description if anybody knows, have experience with this vehicle, in the comments. But anyways, let's look over here. Here's the steering wheel. Now you notice the gauge cluster is not right there between the steering wheel. It's actually right there in the center, which is pretty good because usually the steering wheel sometimes gets in the way of that. And it's easier to watch the road and at the same time see the gauges. So that's pretty neat. So on the steering wheel, you do have some buttons, and this is a very good safety feature, having buttons on the steering wheel to keep your hands on the wheel, eyes on the road. It is a kind of a synthetic, very durable feeling synthetic steering wheel, and with some decent thickness and comfort. But here on the steering wheel is your volume control for your radio, and you can change through your presets there on that side. And in pushing mode, we'll cycle through between AM, FMs, you know, your different ways of playing music, basically. Down here is your Bluetooth controls for your phone. And once you pair your Bluetooth phone with the system, you can answer calls with this button, hang up on calls with that button. And this is for not only making calls, so you can push that button and say call a certain person, say John Smith, that happens to be in your phone book. Or you can push that button and say go to a certain station, tune to a certain station. There's different commands that you can say other than just making calls with the voice recognition system. Very good safety feature. All right, so on this side, these buttons correspond with this screen up here. So let's see if I can get a good shot of the screen. And I'm going to cycle through it so you can see what I'm talking about. There's your speedometer and then what gear you're in and your fuel gauge. But right here, and also you have a clock on that side, but right there in the center, you have this really graphic intensive screen here that gives you a pretty good amount of information. So I'm going to just cycle down. I'm going to scroll down. Basically, you see that eye right here? That eye. So I'm in the information portion of this left and right part, but I can scroll up and down once I get into that portion. I'll show you. So going to the right, this is showing your compass.
Going to the right, this shows you music. Going to the right again shows you a pretty awesome clock. Right again will show you messages. And look at that 80s style, I don't know what, a grid. That's pretty cool. All right, and then you can go into some settings if you want to do that, and then back to the information. So that's what I mean by left and right. You have these different options. So now that I'm in this screen, I can scroll down and get more information. So this screen is letting me know that the what is powering what. So your engine, you have your engine, you have your electric motor, and then you have your battery. So as you're driving, your engine will not only power your wheels, but it also charge your battery. So, and it'll have these little lines that connect. I'm actually going to go ahead and put it in drive and see if I can get it to do something here. Okay, so now it's showing me that this, the battery is powering the electric motor, and the electric motor is powering the wheels. So that's how that rolls. I'm going to put it in reverse. So you can see it actually shows what's powering what. When the engine turns on, it'll have a little line showing the engine powering the wheels, or the engine powering and charging the battery. So pretty cool system there, so you can know what's really going on with the what's powering your vehicle. All right, so let me go ahead and scroll down. This is a meter. Okay, so this is letting you know whether you are in eco mode, whether you are in power. I'll show you. Right now we're in EV mode. Okay, so there's these different buttons here. So and I don't want to make it sound too complicated. It's very easy. It's all automatically does everything. So you can have the EV, right, which is right now. We're just using the electric motor. But as it changes, it'll have an indicator there and let you know basically what's happening. Scrolling down again, you give a eco score. Okay, so the engine just started back up. So let me scroll back up here. So now you see the engine's powering and charging the battery. So if I were to put it in drive now, it's going to show you that the engine's not only charging the battery, but also powering the wheel. All right, so let me go back to where it was. So you have an eco score that just scores you for your driving. See, the vehicle can only do so much with saving gas. It's up to you to not floor it everywhere you go. I'm trying to drive easy. So it'll give you a meter there, the way you start, the way you cruise, the way you stop, and it'll give you a score. And the better your score is, the better gas mileage you're going to get. And this is your fuel consumption, your current, and as you're driving. So it's not going to show anything right now because we're not driving. And then this gives you your range. And there's just a blank screen in case all that stuff's distracting you. Then it scrolls back to this little screen here with the car. So it's not very complicated. I know I'm probably not the best person to, probably didn't explain it in the best way, but it's, it uses the gas. If you just drive the car, you don't really have to worry about all that stuff, but you do have the ability to, if you're curious, to know what's powering the vehicle in the moment, what kind of gas mileage you get, and all that kind of stuff. And of course, you can always just drive it the way you want to, and it's still going to be good on gas. It's just, if you're really conscious about gas mileage, you can really dig in there and try to improve your score on the screen. So this is the start button, and to start the vehicle, you just get in and push your foot on the brake and push the power button. So when you push that power button, sometimes the engine is not going to start, but it'll say ready. It'll pop up right here and say ready. So that means you can actually just start driving. You don't have to wait for the engine to start. It's going to power off the battery or the electric motor and stuff like that. So when you get in a hybrid vehicle like this, you get in, you push the start button, engine doesn't always start. You can still drive though. It's kind of different if you've never experienced that. Okay, so here's your radio entertainment screen. And so I have the volume button on this side, tune to the stations on that side. CD player here. You can eject your CD. You can also go into the different audio settings. But just to show you, right now we're in the satellite radio portion of the screen. But let me hit source and we'll go into, I just want to show you how many different ways you can play music through the sound system besides your CD player and stuff. So AM, FM, satellite radio, you have a CD, USB, Bluetooth audio, auxiliary input, and you have an AV input. And you can actually watch a video on this screen when you're in park. So as long as you're not driving, you can actually watch a video on the screen. That's pretty neat. So there's the audio. You can go in apps, and this is where you can find your navigation. And you know, you see, you can see where you're at. You can zoom in and out if you want to kind of get your bearings. And also, if you wanted to, you can put in a destination. And you can put in a specific address, a point of interest. You can go in your address book. Also, you can save your home address to where you can go home at any time, anywhere in the United States. You just hit go home, it takes you back home. All right, speaking of home, let's go to the home screen, which shows you a split between your radio and your navigation screen. And also, once you pair your, you can also pair a Bluetooth phone, and it's not going to do it now because I'm not pairing one, but you'll be have the ability to make calls with a keypad there. Plus, you'll have your phone book and access to all that good stuff. So, pretty functional and easy to use touchscreen here, right there in the center. And your climate control is down here. So you have some buttons around the outside, and then you have this this display. So right now, I want to just show you that you push this left and right. And so you got your temperature. Once you choose that selection, you can move this dial. I can choose over there to the fan speed and move the dial. So the dial does different things besides just, you know, one feature. So you just choose the feature you want, and then you can use it on that feature. And then you recirculate the air. You have your defrosters. You can turn it off if you wanted to. And then you have your air conditioning there. All right, so let's look at the shifter. This is a little bit different than the average car. So let me just go ahead and run this by you. When you put it in park, you just push this button. So right now it's in park, and I'm going to go ahead and just put it in neutral. So I push it over here to neutral, and I hold it there, and it goes into neutral. So now I'm in neutral, and it'll tell you what gear you're in up here. Okay, so now I want to go in reverse. I bring it over and go up. And when I put it in reverse, the backup camera pops up here with the guidelines and the red, do not get any closer than that line. The purpose of that red line, I know it looks like you have lots of room, but actually this is a very distorted fisheye lens. So this distance between that red line and your vehicle is only a few inches. Down here it's several feet. So that distortion can be disorienting, but the guidelines really help out with that. All right, so, and you, when you're in reverse, it beeps at you to let you know you're in reverse the whole time to let you know. So let me go ahead and take it out of reverse by pushing it over and then down, and you can see over and down is drive. So now I'm in drive, and I can drive around or whatever. And even if the engine's not running, it, you still can use the battery power to power the vehicle. So that's, you know, just keep that in mind. Just because you don't hear an engine run doesn't mean it's not ready to go. It'll actually say ready up there. So so also, you have this other thing, this B right here. Now that's not a gear per se. That is a engine braking feature. So if you're going down a hill and you want to use some of the regenerative braking, so you can hold this down or push it down, and it goes into that mode to where when you let go of the accelerator, the engine braking is going to slow you down automatically. Sort of like the engines, you're actually slowing down with the brakes in a way. It's not quite as severe, but it does actually, you know, slow you down. And it, as it's slowing you down, is using your forward momentum to recharge the battery. So that's a really cool feature. The wheels actually can be able to turn a kind of a generator and regenerate the battery as you're going downhill. So that's what that's for. All right, so anytime, at any gear you're in, you can always push this button, and that's how you go in the park. So hopefully you understand, it's a little tiny shifter. It's a little bit, it's quite different than the average shifter. But, you know, once you get used to it, it's a piece of cake to use. And it's, you know, it's well placed, it's right there, and easy to get to. Okay, so under here we have a 12-volt power supply. Also, you have a USB and an auxiliary input over here. If you can see that.
And then this is 12 volt, old school cigarette lighter style.
Power supply, you have a place to put some papers or something there. And a really good storage bin right here in the middle. And there's a cup holder, a single lone cup holder. And to the left of the cup holder, you have these different drive modes. So EV is basically electric vehicle. So you want to just drive on the electric part of the vehicle, just right off the battery and not the engine, you can push that. Eco mode cycles back and forth. Now this is limited. You can't go that far with it like that. The eco mode is basically it cycles back and forth. Try to give you the best gas mileage with the combination of the engine and the electric motor. Power mode gives you the most power out of the vehicle, so it's going to use the engine more and stuff like that, so it gives you the most power that you can get out of this vehicle. All right, so there's the center armrest, and this lifts up, and in here you'll find a storage bin with this little removable tray, and you have lots of room in there. Not too big though, so it's not going to be too cluttered up. And then they got the little tray that goes back in place for quick access stuff. Alright, let's take a look at the rear view mirror. It does have the standard flippy thing for day and night mode. Up here, you have a place to put your sunglasses. Tap lights for a quick reading light individually, or you can turn all the interior lights on with that button. Center position is they turn on with the door. And then this is off. Even if the door opens, the interior lights do not turn on. And this is your microphone here for your Bluetooth system. So now you know where the microphone is. And they do have in the visors these mirrors, and it has these lights that turn on with the mirror. So it just has to be in a certain position for the light to turn on. All right, so let's take a look back here and look at the visibility. All right, there you have it, 2015 Toyota Prius V, and I appreciate you watching. If you have any questions, any clarifications, anything like that, if you have any experience with one of these vehicles, you took one for a test drive, or possibly you own one and you drive one every day, or you know what this thing is, then you can let me know in the comment section. I'd really appreciate it. So thank you for watching, and thank you to Sparks Toyota for allowing me to show off an awesome car. And I'll see y'all next time.